Allah pardon us by the Qur'an and make it our guide, light and mercy. Allah let us memorize what we've forgotten of it and educate us what we've missed, what we've missed. Oh Allah, grant us the ability to recite it day and night and make it an argument.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to a new episode of your show In the Light of the Quran. Now today's light, we will take it from the Surah of Al-Isra. The Surah of Al-Isra talks about the incident where Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was taken by the angel Jibreel, peace be upon him, to Jerusalem, to Baytul Maqdis. Then they both ascended to the heavens. The verses today talk about a very beautiful subject that deals with one of the rights of human beings, the human rights. And this actually gives us a glimpse on the human rights in Islam generally. Because the first way of life to bring dignity and honor to the human soul, regardless of the background or the color or the language or the standard of living, was Islam. And it remains with the most perfect system of human rights. And other human ways of bringing dignity to the human or other ways or other forms of human rights actually, they are not in total agreement with the human nature, and there is a lot of contradiction among them, especially in the application. Now let's see what the verses say to delve into their meaning inshallah and get the benefits out of that. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ وَحَمَلْنَاهُمْ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ وَرَزَقْنَاهُمْ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَفَضَّلْنَاهُمْ عَلَى كَثِيرٍ مِّمَّنْ خَلَقْنَا تَفْضِيلًا يَوْمَ نَدْعُو كُلَّ أُنَاسٍ بِإِمَامِهِمْ فَمَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ فَأُولَئِكَ يَقْرَؤُونَ كِتَابَهُمْ وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ فَتِيلًا وَمَنْ كَانَ فِي هَذِهِ أَعْمَى فَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ أَعْمَى وَأَضَلُّ سَبِيلًا وَإِنْ كَادُوا لَيَفْتِنُونَكَ عَنِ الَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ لِتَفْتَرِيَ عَلَيْنَا غَيْرَهُ وَإِذَا لَاتَّخَذُوكَ خَلِيلًا وَلَوْلَا أَنْ ثَبَّتْنَاكَ لَقَدْ كِدْتَ تَرْكَنُ إِلَيْهِمْ شَيْئًا قَلِيلًا إذا لأذقناك ضعف الحياة وضعف الممات ثم لا تجد لك علينا نصيرا وإن كادوا ليستفزونك من الأرض ليخرجوك منها وإذا لا يلبثون خلافك إلا قليلا سنة من قد أرسلنا قبلك من رسلنا ولا تجد لسنتنا تحويلا. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back. Now these beautiful verses from Surah Al-Isra, they start with a very important Islamic statement. Allah says clearly in the Quran that we have honored the children of Adam. Means we have honored mankind, all of them. So mankind is honored in general. The human race is honored in Al-Islam. Human life is honored in Al-Islam. Now this actually answers to the misconceptions and the lies against Islam that the Muslims only appreciate Muslims. On the contrary, the Muslims or the Islamic life in general is honored in Islam. All mankind are honored by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now this honor takes a lot of or different shapes. The first thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made mankind among the elite of the creatures. All the creation. Allah has favored us above so many of His creation. Allah gave us a special position, special abilities. So many things, so many merits, so many gifts we were given. But sometimes, unfortunately, this is part of the human nature. We are unaware of what we have, or at least we do not appreciate. Part of the human nature is that we always look at, or we always aspire what other people have. We always aspire what we don't have, and we fail to appreciate what we have. But the human self, human beings have a lot of treasures inside them. Psychological, mental, intellectual, physical, so many things that Allah has given us, so many treasures inside us, and it is our duty to dig them up and try to find them and utilize them and benefit from them. Now let me start to mention some of the honors that Allah has given mankind. The first honor Allah gave mankind is that Allah, before He created mankind, He spoke to the angels and He said to them, I will create a successor on earth, someone or a generation or a creation to be in charge of the earth, to take care of the earth, to cultivate it, to build it, to develop it. This is the position of mankind, and they will succeed each other. The generations of the humankind will succeed each other. So this is the first honor. Allah mentioned them to the angels with this description, beautiful description, with this beautiful duty to the angels. Then the second honor Allah gave mankind, Allah created our father Adam, the first human being. Allah created him with His own hands. Allah, as Allah states clearly in the Qur'an, that He created Adam with His own hands. Now Allah creates so many things. Allah created so many things in this universe by saying kun, by saying be, and it is with one word, and this thing would happen to be, that's it. But as for mankind, as for Adam, Allah created him with His own hands. So this is an honor that was not given to most of the creatures, most of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, this is why Satan was jealous of Adam. Then the second honor Allah gave Adam is that He blew the soul in him. Allah Himself blew the soul into Adam, so Adam became alive. Now, there's another honor that Allah gave Adam. He said to the angels, prostrate yourselves before Adam. Allah made Adam the direction of the prostration of the angels. Could you see the honor that Allah is giving the human being? Allah has honored us so much even before our creation, even at the early stages of our creation, and at the time of our father Adam, and even until today we are still honored, but we have to appreciate this. To maintain this honor, we have to appreciate it. We have to be thankful to it. The other honor Allah gave mankind, Allah gave them the ability to remember and the ability to use language and to invent language, to create a new language. And this is the honor that Allah, or the favor Allah gave mankind above the angels. Now when Allah wanted to create Adam, the angels said, why do you create a creation that will bring mischief and shed blood on earth? Allah said, I know what you do not know and what you do not know. Then when Adam was created, Allah said to the angels, Allah showed the angels and displayed some of His creatures. And He said to the angels, tell me the names of these. They could not. The angels do not have the ability to learn by themselves. The only way they can learn is by Allah teaching them. They cannot learn. They don't have the process of learning. They do not have the ability to learn new things unless Allah teaches them. So the angels said, we do not know. We do not know the names of these. You are the all-knowing. You are the wise. So Allah said to Adam, tell them the names of these. So Adam told them the names of these objects. So it shows that Adam has the ability to learn and has the ability to give things names. So this is why when human beings discover a new thing or manufacture a new thing, they have the ability to give names. This is human nature. And this is an honor that we are given. The animals, they don't have even the ability to speak. They don't have the language in the sense that we have as human beings. They don't have the ability to give things names. This is an honor we are given. So we have to appreciate this. Now another honor we are given, that Allah put our father Adam in paradise, and Allah made it our home, our first home, paradise. And if we do righteousness, we will inshallah get back to paradise. Now the honor that we are given as human beings on this earth is that Allah sent to us the guidance. Allah sent to us the guidance of Islam. Allah, another honor that we are given is that Allah sent us Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. People were living in darkness. People were killing each other, were raping the women of each other. They were doing a lot of indecency, a lot of evil things, a lot of wrong practices that destroyed the society, destroyed the individual, destroyed the values, destroyed the shyness and the beauty of the human soul. But Allah sent Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam with the guidance of the Qur'an, with the light of the Qur'an. Now the light of the Qur'an that we are trying to take is a wonderful gift from Allah, and it's a sign that Allah has honored us. Allah has honored us with this Qur'an. As Muslims, we are honored with the message of Islam. We are honored with the Qur'an and with the example of Prophet Muhammad. So we have to be thankful to this. How can we be thankful to this? It's by living by this light. It's by understanding this light and living by it and getting into it and trying to digest it, trying to make it part of our makeup. This is how we appreciate this honor that Allah has given us. Part of the honor that we are given is that the skills and the abilities and the capacities that Allah put in us. We are full with a lot of gifts, a lot of abilities, a lot of skills, but we need to cultivate them, we need to sharpen them. This is part of being thankful to them. You know, this honor that is given to us, if we are not thankful to it, or if we are not thankful for it, then it will be taken away from us. This is why the disbelievers are not thankful for the gift of the guidance of the Qur'an. They have rejected it. This is why this honor will be taken away from them on the Day of Judgment, and they will dwell in the hellfire forever. And the Muslims, the more they apply the religion of Islam and live by the light of the Qur'an, Allah will give them more honor in this life. But if they fail to do that as we have failed today, then Allah will take this honor from us. So part of the preserving the honor that Allah gave us is to cultivate ourselves and build the skills that Allah has given us. All the talents that you have, sharpen them, benefit from them, and use them for the goodness of the religion of Islam. Then Allah says in this verse, and we have carried the sons of Adam on land and on sea. Allah has subjected all everything in this universe for our own benefit. Imagine the honor that Allah has given us. So why don't we be appreciative? Why don't we thank Allah for all the things, all the gifts that He has given us? This is our duty. Then Allah talks about the end of the ones who will preserve this honor, when the people will be called by their leaders, by their imams on the Day of Judgment. Those who take their records, their books with the right hands, these are the ones who will preserve their honor, and they will have more honor on the Day of Judgment. And everyone will read their book and will recognize their own actions, and then will face the consequences of their actions. And the ones who were blind from the light of the Quran in this world will be blind on the Day of Judgment and will be humiliated and will lose all the honor Allah prepared for the believers. Then Allah talks about the honor He gave to Prophet Muhammad, that He made him firm in the face of all the challenges and calamities. Now the light that we took today is that we are honored. We are inheritedly honored as human beings. Let's preserve this honor with the light of the Quran. Let's magnify it with the light of the Quran and benefit from it and apply it in our lives. Until we meet next time with another light from the Quran, I leave you in peace. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allah pardon us by the Quran. Allah pardon us by the Quran. And make it our guide, light and mercy. Allah, let us memorize what we've forgotten of it, and educate us what we've missed, what we've missed. Oh Allah, grant us the ability to recite it, to recite it.